Hi, everyone. My name is Sai Vennam, and I'm with the IBM Cloud team. Did you know that according to a recent study, only 20% of enterprise applications have moved to the cloud? Well, let's talk about why exactly that is. Well, we know that container technology is crucial for making that transition to the cloud. But even with businesses adopting it, they're still running into a number of roadblocks. Say, for example, that a business is creating a new cloud-native application, but the pace at which it's progressing is much faster than the legacy data layer can scale. Now, this is just one use case. IBM has identified key challenges preventing businesses from moving to the cloud and created what we're calling IBM Cloud Paks. Now, let's start building out the stack that supports Cloud Paks. It starts with Red Hat OpenShift. Now, OpenShift is their flagship container platform, and essentially, it's based on container and Kubernetes technology. So with Cloud Paks, what we've done is we've taken IBM middleware, packaged it up, but more importantly, optimized it to run directly on top of OpenShift. This means it runs best in a OpenShift or container-based environment. So up here, we have Cloud Paks. Now, since Cloud Paks are supported on OpenShift, now we have to think about where OpenShift is supported. And the great thing is, OpenShift is actually supported anywhere. So any major public cloud provider, or maybe on-prem or a private cloud, the experience for getting Cloud Paks on IBM Cloud is actually very streamlined. And we're going to have a future video that goes through that entire experience. Now, we've built out the groundwork here, but the last layer that we haven't mentioned is going to be the actual applications or the business logic that actually leverages those Cloud Paks. And that's where the user and the customer comes in to actually build out. Now, there's three key tenants to Cloud Paks that I want to outline. So for one, they can run anywhere. We talked about this. So regardless of where your OpenShift platform is running, so on-prem or public or private clouds, or even running on IBM Cloud, you can run those Cloud Paks in a fully supported fashion anywhere. Next, we have the idea that they're open as well as secure. Now, we mentioned that they're built and optimized for OpenShift, which is based on open source technology and principles. This allows you to avoid vendor lock-in and basically run these applications and logic anywhere. In addition, it's secure from the ground up. So essentially, we have security patches as well as updates to the platform, regardless of whether it's the operating system, OpenShift, or the entire set of IBM-certified middleware through the Cloud Paks. Now, the last thing that we have here is the fact that they're consumable. Now, Cloud Paks are consumable in the sense that you can not only pay for what you need, but also when you need it. In addition, since we package them up into these clear use cases, these five that we have here, they essentially allow you to consume the particular solution that you need that's mitigating or preventing you from making that transition to the cloud. Now, we'll start by actually going through each of these different Cloud Paks now. At the top, we have Cloud Pak for Apps. Cloud Pak for Apps essentially allows you to, whether or not you're creating new cloud-native assets or modernizing maybe an existing application, it kind of allows you to get started on the right foot. So creating a new microservice, you have to think maybe you want it to run on any cloud environment. In addition, taking advantage of certified and secure runtimes and capabilities. So we have the tools to let you do that. In addition, say you have legacy infrastructure or application workloads, particularly those based on WebSphere, we have prescribed approaches to modernize those. Next, we have Cloud Pak for Data. Now, data is crucial to any application. And over the years, or maybe decades, businesses have accrued lots and lots of data. But the problem is a majority of that data is uncatalogued or maybe even inaccessible. But businesses know that if they were to leverage all of that data, they could really get new analytics and insights. Now, Cloud Pak for Data gives you a single pane, allowing you to connect up all of those data sources and then start infusing AI and machine learning to derive new insights from those capabilities. That's the power of this Cloud Pak. Next, we have Cloud Pak for Automation. Now, every business kind of has these everyday mundane tasks, things that can be automated. So for example, invoices that need to be approved or documents that need to make sure that they're following the right guidelines. Now, this Cloud Pak allows you to automate those everyday processes, allowing your employees to focus on the higher value tasks. Next, we have Cloud Pak for Integration. Now, in previous videos, we've talked about this emergent pattern of applications, essentially applications that are basically hybrid cloud or following a hybrid cloud architecture. So apps that are running legacy on-prem, as well as newer apps running in the cloud. Now, those disparate environments, to kind of get them to work holistically, you may take advantage of something like APIs and API management. Or maybe you're taking advantage of a faster protocol, something like messages with Kafka. Regardless, when it comes to integrating these different solutions and having them work with each other, that's where Cloud Pak for Integration comes in. Last but not least, we have the Cloud Pak for Multi-Cloud Management. Now, the future is not just hybrid, but also multi-cloud. This means maybe you're taking advantage of multiple cloud or multiple public cloud providers. Now, in this case, there's three major things to think about. How do you govern all of those environments? So things like security and compliance policies. How do you automate deployment of assets to those environments? And finally, how do you get visibility? Things like metrics and analytics on those apps, or just to make sure that they're healthy. That's where this final Cloud Pak for Multi-Cloud Management comes in. Now, bringing all of this together, we have IBM Cloud Paks, essentially allowing you to reduce your speed for development as well as your operational expenses. Thanks for joining me for this quick overview of IBM Cloud Paks. As always, you can get started quickly by creating a free account on IBM Cloud. If you have any questions or simply like the video, be sure to drop a like or a comment below. Stay tuned for more videos like this in the future. Thank you.